Introduction: six-pack abs seems to be the magical unicorn that so many people are chasing after but never seem to catch. Many people wonder why they don't have six-pack abs. That question is a bit confusing, however, because in truth we all have abs. Of course, having abs and having a six-pack are obviously two very different things in some people's mind. The truth of the matter is we all have the same abdominal muscles. What we do with them, how we work them, and how we try to define them is up to us. Every single person has a six-pack, just the same as every single person has a pair of biceps. The shape and definition of your six-pack is dependent on many factors, just like the shape and size of your biceps. Unfortunately, your genetics is not something that you can change. You can't change your body type any more than you can change your height. That is why you see that having visible abs is easy for some people and difficult for others. To many people, a six-pack is the ultimate goal when it comes to working out. This makes sense in a way, because whenever you are losing weight, the abs are the last thing to appear. You have probably experienced this before. You are trying to lose weight and you notice differences in your shoulders and arms, but nothing really in your abs. That is because when you lose fat, your body works from the outside in. That is why the abs are so hard to uncover. You have to realize that your body doesn't care about how you look. Your body is only interested in survival. Your body doesn't think that single-digit body fat is a good idea, so it takes work and determination. However, that can be said of anything worth having. The bottom line is that everyone has abs. The reason that everyone doesn't have visible abs depends on a variety of factors. For some people it is genetic, for other people it is lack of consistent effort, or simply not wanting to change. However, no matter what anyone says or tries to tell you, you do have abs. Now it's up to you and the help of this guide to transform them into a six-pack. Whether or not you put in the work, and take the time to reveal it is up to you. Chapter 1, Is getting six-pack abs is even possible for you? With all the products out there promoting six-pack abs, it is obvious that a lot of people need help. The majority of people struggle with it so much that many people just give up and think that it is impossible. One thing you have to realize is that in order for you to have a visible six-pack, you have to reach a certain body fat percentage. You can increase the visual appeal of your abs by doing ab work and building the muscles. However, if you are still carrying too much body fat, they will not be well defined. So in order to have visible abs, you have to reduce body fat. This is easier for some people than others, but everyone can do it. There are many factors that go into weight loss. Calories consumed and calories burned are just a small part of it. You also have to consider your genetics, body type, and hormonal interaction. All of these factors can add up and complicate the process. People either get overwhelmed by all the different aspects, or they completely overlook some of them. Either way, this can make it seem like building a six-pack is impossible. You can feel like you are doing everything right. You can be eating perfectly, you can be training well, and some other hidden factor can be slowing you down. Sometimes simple things such as stress or lack of sleep can throw your hormones out of balance and cause you to retain water. The water you retain can hide the progress you are making, and you start to get frustrated. Once you get frustrated, you get more stressed, and it can become a vicious cycle. However, the truth is that everyone can develop their abs. The main variable is how long it will take. Some people always seem to have abs no matter what they do or eat. For other people, it is going to take a lot of work, and it is going to be frustrating. Like with most anything else training related, consistency is the key to success. If you stay consistent and monitor all the aspects of your training, life, and environment, then you can build an awesome set of visible abs. Chapter 2, Important things to consider when beginning ab training. Training your abs is no different than training any other muscle. If you want results, you have to have a plan and you have to put forth consistent effort. Another thing to consider with ab training is that you have to be patient. The abs are always the last thing to reveal themselves, so it makes sense that they will take the most time to develop. Three things to consider when beginning ab training: it's going to take longer than you expect, it's going to be harder than you thought, you are going to have to diet. It cannot be overemphasized that getting a six-pack is really hard work. The problem is there are so many infomercials out there that tell you that you can have a six-pack in 8 weeks. And even though you know that isn't likely, it is hard to resist the temptation to believe it. We all fall victim to such promises, and when we constantly see these types of ads, it is hard not to have an unrealistic expectation on how long it will take. The problem is that when you set unrealistic expectations, chances are you will fail. And when you fail to reach your goal in the time you decided, you are likely to get frustrated and give up. Once you give up the first time, it gets harder and harder to start again because you don't expect it to work. This happens in all areas of fitness, but seems to happen the most when it comes to building a six-pack. The reason is that having a six-pack is directly tied to your body fat percentage. You cannot have a six-pack with a high level of body fat, so diet is always a major factor. People are constantly going on diets for a few weeks, not dropping weight as fast as they want, and ultimately quitting. The yo-yo diet syndrome is definitely something that you want to avoid. Besides the time factor, another thing to consider is lower back training. As with all your training, you want to make sure your physique is balanced. If you significantly increase your ab training without increasing your lower back training, then you will develop muscular imbalances. This is a recipe for disaster and can lead to lower back issues or injury. Take this into consideration when you plan your training. The bottom line is, before you have any visions of washboard abs and start to train abs, be realistic about how long it is going to take and balance out your training. Just realize it is going to take longer than you want, and it is going to be more work than you want to do. However, the payoff will be worth it. Once you reach your goal, you will have a sense of accomplishment, and an awesome six-pack too. Chapter 3, Nutrition Guidelines for Six-Pack Abs. As important as training is, when it comes to abs, diet is more important. No other muscle group is as dependent on diet as the abs, because abs take a certain body fat percentage to appear. While it is true that you can build the abs to be more visible, you still are going to have to drop body fat to have a six-pack. In this part, we are going to look at 5 nutrition tips for six-pack abs: eliminate sugar, increase protein consumption, eat healthy fats, eat whole unprocessed foods, drink lots of water, eliminate sugar. Pretty much every piece of diet advice will tell you to reduce or eliminate sugar intake. This list is obviously no exception. The main problem with sugar is that it causes an insulin spike. Once insulin is present, all fat burning comes to a halt. If you want your body to be a fat-burning machine, then you have to keep blood sugar levels steady and reduce the effects of insulin. That is not to say that you have to avoid carbs altogether. A quality post-workout shake with carbs in it is a good way to replenish glycogen in the muscle and help you recover. Increase protein consumption. While you do need a caloric deficit to lose weight, you don't want to lose the muscle you have built. If you are lowering carb intake, then you have to get those calories from somewhere else. Consuming protein in the form of lean cuts of meat is optimal. Protein shakes are convenient, but it is better to get most of your calories from whole foods. Drinking your calories does not give you the same level of satisfaction, and being in a caloric deficit is hard enough. Also, there is a thermogenic effect of digesting foods that you do not get when you drink your calories. Eat healthy fats. No matter what you may hear, low-fat diets are ineffective. Your body needs good healthy fats. You also have to consider that the more fat that you consume, the more efficient you become at processing it. If you reduce your fat intake, then your body does not produce as many fat-burning enzymes. So you should include healthy fats in your meal plans. Just pay attention to your calories, as fats are very calorie-dense. Eat whole unprocessed foods. This is good advice whether you want abs or not. Both from a health standpoint and from a dieting standpoint, it is best to consume unprocessed foods. These foods have more nutritional value, and when you are reducing calories, you need the most nutrient-dense foods you can find. Drink lots of water. Hydration is important whether you are dieting or not. However, when you are dieting, it can help for numerous reasons. Drinking lots of water helps you to feel full and reduces hunger cravings. It is a fact that the more water that you drink, the more water that you excrete. You can reduce your water retention by drinking more water, and the less water you retain, the more visible your abs are. None of these suggestions are particularly exciting. In fact, you will probably find these on every diet tips list you ever read. There is a reason for that: they work. People are always looking for shortcuts to dieting and getting abs, but shortcuts are worthless if you don't cover the basics first. If you cover the basics on this list first, you will make your ab training that much more effective, and you'll see your abs sooner. Chapter 4, Some Superfoods to Maximize Your Ab Progress. There are a lot of factors when it comes to building six-pack abs. Some of them, like genetics, are beyond your control. However, training and diet are two things you can control. Make no mistake about it, ab training is very important. However, your dream of abs lives and dies with your diet. You can do all the work you want in the gym, and completely sabotage your results in the kitchen. Since abs are the last to appear and the first to disappear, diet will always play a huge part in how your six-pack looks. How restrictive you have to be within regards to diet depends on many things. However, just when you might start to think it is impossible to get your six-pack, there is good news. There are actually superfoods that can help speed up the fat loss process and bring your abs out for the entire world to see. 5 Superfoods for Six-Pack Abs: Whole Eggs, Grass-Fed Butter, Grass-Fed Beef, Wild Fish, Dark Leafy Greens. Whole Eggs. You might not expect eggs to be on this list, but they are an excellent source of protein. They have a very impressive amino acid profile, and they offer good fats. Eggs will not only help with fat loss, but they will help you build muscle. This is a 1-2 punch when it comes to building a six-pack. It is important to note that when it comes to eggs, you should be eating free-range organic grass-fed butter. I am sure you think that butter will make you fat. The truth is, depends on the type of butter. Grass-fed butter is one of the best sources of conjugated linoleic acid, CLA. CLA has been shown to not only help with weight loss, but increase your resistance to carcinogens. Not only that, but it has a great ration of omega-3 to omega-6 fatty acids. Grass-fed beef. Much like butter, grass-fed beef has many more health benefits than your average ground beef. It has been shown to have 10 times the beta-carotene, 3 times the vitamin E, and 3 times the omega-3 fatty acids. Wild fish. We all know that fish oil is a powerful supplement, and that we eat far too much omega-6 and not enough omega-3. Wild-caught fish are full of healthy omega-3s as well as being high in protein. Dark leafy greens. We all know we need to eat more vegetables, but when it comes to six-pack abs, Popeye was right. Dark leafy greens such as spinach, kale, and bok choy are perfect superfoods for your six-pack plans. They help you reach your nutritional requirements, and a great source of vitamins and minerals, and have very few calories. They are nutrient-dense foods, and when you are dieting, it is a necessity. I hope this list of superfoods helps in your awareness of superfoods that can have a big impact on your diet and in revealing those six-pack abs. Chapter 5, Top Dietary Supplements for Your Ab Goal. We cannot get away from the fact that diet has a huge impact on our quest for six-pack abs. What you eat has a huge impact on your results. The supplement industry knows this, and makes billions of dollars each year selling you quick-fix solutions to your problems. Unfortunately, most of the supplements out there are nothing more than snake oil. They are here today, gone tomorrow, and when they leave, they take your hard-earned money with them. The best supplements are the ones that have stood the test of time. People spend too much time looking for the latest and greatest shortcut. The truth is, if you want six-pack abs, you are going to have to work for it, and it is going to take longer than you want. To help speed up the process though, here are some solid supplement choices. 5 Best Supplements for Six-Pack Abs: Caffeine, CLA, Yohimbe, Synephrine, Green Tea. Caffeine. Not only does your morning coffee help you wake up in the morning, it aids in fat loss. Caffeine is a CNS stimulant that binds to fat and enhances fat burning. Unfortunately, your body can become immune to your normal caffeine dose, so it may be necessary to cycle on and off from time to time to get the same effect. CLA-conjugated linoleic acid is a healthy fat that is a true powerhouse when it comes to six-pack abs. It has been shown to boost strength, shred body fat, and build muscle. CLA actually blocks certain fat-storing enzymes, thus preventing the storage of fat. Yohimbe. You will find yohimbe in most fat-burning stacks. Its effects are well documented. It works in a different method from other fat burnings in that it blocks the alpha receptors on fat cells. Yohimbe can be taken orally, or if you find it in a cream form you can apply it directly to the ab area. Synephrine, we all know the caffeine, ephedrine and aspirin stack work well for fat loss. Unfortunately ephedrine is no longer available. Synephrine has a similar chemical structure to ephedrine, but it increases fat burning without increasing your heart rate or raising your blood pressure. Green tea contains catechins. EGCG is the main catechin, and it is responsible for the thermogenic effects of green tea. EGCG works to inhibit norepinephrine breakdown, which allows you to maintain a high level of calorie burning. This might not be an exciting list, but the truth is these supplements work. You can waste your time with the latest and greatest, or you can stick to the basics. There is a reason these supplements have been around forever. Add them to your mix and you will see an increase in your results. Chapter 6 to 5 All-Time Best Ab Exercises. For many people, ab training just means lying on the floor and doing crunches. They think that if they just do 1,000 crunches a day they will have six-pack abs in 8 weeks. Who can blame them, since they are constantly shown commercials for workouts promising just that? Unfortunately, we all know that is not true. To really build a six-pack you have to mix up your exercises and hit the abs from different angles. Top 5 ab exercises: standing cable pull-down, ab wheel, bicycle crunches, reverse crunches, leg raises, standing cable pull-down. One thing people seem to forget is that the abs are muscles. They respond to weighted training as well. The standing cable pull-down is an excellent way to add some weight into your ab training. It also works your abs while standing, which is important if you are an athlete. Ab wheel. Before there were planks, there was the ab wheel. This is one of best toys you can buy for the gym. It hits the abs just as hard as planks, and allows you to do all kinds of variations. Even better news is that they are relatively inexpensive and can fit in your gym bag. Bicycle crunches. Oftentimes when it comes to ab training we only work in one plane. However, the abs are built to perform in numerous planes. Adding some twisting to your ab exercises is a great way to stimulate new muscles like the oblique and serratus. Reverse crunches. We spend so much time focusing on the upper abs that we often forget about the lower abs. This imbalance can cause a number of problems. Besides building a midsection that is not symmetrical, you are setting yourself up for an injury. While ab muscles are very resistant to injury, if you happen to pull one you will remember it forever. Leg raises. This is one of the best lower ab exercises there is. You can do this in a variety of ways. You can use a chin-up bar or a Roman chair. You can do them with straight or bent legs as well. Whichever combination that you choose to use, just be consistent in doing them. They really will help round out your ab development. This is just a short list of ab exercises to help add some variety to your training. If you need any help with how to perform the exercise or technique, just perform a search on Google and you will find a whole array of descriptions, demonstrations and variations. Don't get stuck in the rut of thinking that crunches are the only thing you can do. You have to mix it up in order to keep your body growing. Don't let your progress stagnate or allow yourself to get bored. If you stick with it, you will eventually reach your six-pack goals.